Let's have a look at another question. The brother has asked a question, how to have authentic knowledge of Islam. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Rabbi Surah Al-Zadari wa Sili Amri wa Ahla Lugdata Milizani Yaqu Qali. In order to have the proper knowledge of Islam, we have to go back to our original sources. That is a Quran, and the second is Hadith. But when we talk about Hadith, we also have to understand something. There is a difference between the science of Hadith and the classification of Hadith. So majority of the Muslims who does not have a knowledge of an Islam, they usually get confused about which Hadith are the authentic, which Hadith are the Daif, Sahih, and Hasan, and Ahad, and all that classifications of Hadith. So they have to understand, and they have to go more deep study into that. But in order to have like a basic knowledge of Islam, the first thing any new convert Islam or the one who is not has a much knowledge about Islam. So the first thing they have to know, they have to start from the Quran. The first thing they have to do is they have to know the Arabic language, and they have to know the grammar thing. They have to know morphology. They have to know of the Quranic language, and then they have to look at the interpretations, and they have to look into the tafsir, and they have to look what the mufassirs has written in the tafsir, and because they have interpreted and translated the Quran, written the tafsir based on the words, and because each word in the Quran has a very deep meaning, and it has a very broad interpretations of the Quran on every word in the Quran, and they have to know each word, and they have to study. The first thing they have to do is read the Quran, and then the second thing they have to do, they have to read the different translations of the Quran. Like there's a different translations in the market, so he has to read all the translations and try to see which one it is more familiar to him, which is more easy to understand. And then the third step is to read the tafsir of the Quran, which has like very like a sea of knowledge of the tafsir. And then he has to study the Hadith, and from the Hadith he has to analyze the classifications of Hadith, like which one is Sahih Hadith, what is the definition of the Sahih, what is the definition of Hasan Hadith, and what is Daif, and what is fabricated. So he would able to analyze, and he would able to come to the conclusion when based on all the narrators in the Hadith. So he will be able to investigate on each narrator on each Hadith. So this is the basic knowledge how you get into understand the Quranic language and grammar, and has a deep meaning of each word. Go to read the Quran, number one. Number two, read the translations from the different translator, not just like one. Then the third thing you have to do is read the tafsir from not just like one person who wrote the tafsir. And there's a more popular tafsir that is being used in schools, that is like Tafsir Ibn Kathir, that was written by Imam Kathir. And then later he can go more into a deep knowledge and can understand on the Asul al-Fiqh and the Asul al-Sirah and Asul al-Tafsir. So he can read and other knowledge that. But this is the way how you will be able to start getting an education. Read the Quran and the translation from the different translator, and read the tafsir. So he will be able to understand by interpret, and he will be able to get more deep into broad topics in the Quran.